Lift yourself to table position, with your palms under your shoulders and your knees touching under your hips. Take a deep breath, and on the exhalation, lift your right knee out to the side and up into fire hydrant position. Keep both arms straight, 90-degree angles at the knee and the hip, shin parallel to the ground. Lift the knee as high as you can and breathe deeply. Notice where your attention goes. Notice if it flows away from the hip or if it flows into the hip. And see if you can channel your awareness right into the strongest sensation that you feel in the posture. Breathe. The sensations are what is real in this moment. Sometimes our mind weaves a fantasy, a story of escape. That is okay, except sometimes it becomes a habit. Yoga is about being real. Can we be real even when it is not easy? Even when there is strong sensation? Begin to circle the lifted knee. Reach out in ever-widening circles. Keep both arms straight to focus the movement in the hips, pelvis, and lower back. How big can these circles be? And can you stay present for them? Can you feel the circle all the way around? Now straighten your right leg, extending the foot to side kick position, and bring the toes up by your shoulder. Keep both arms straight and press out through the heel until there is equal weight on both hands. Hold this alignment for 3 breaths if you can. When you finish those breaths, bend the knee and place the right foot in between your hands, with the heel a little past your fingertips. Curl your left toes under and lift your left knee to lunge position. The left heel points straight up, the left leg straight. Lower your hips as much as you can and raise your hands to your hips. Lift your pubic bone and drop your tailbone. Bring your torso as vertical as possible. Release your hands down, and on an inhalation, sweep them out to the sides and up overhead. Flare your ribs, roll your shoulders open. Fingertips reach up and back, sternum up and forward. Press your pelvis down, crown of your head reaches for your thumbs. Open your upper body, lengthen your spine. Breathe into whatever stretch you feel in your belly. Focus your gaze on the line in front of you where the wall meets the ceiling. Or for a little more challenge, hold the posture with your eyes closed. On your next exhalation, sweep your arms forward and down. Lower your left knee, right knee moves back by the left. Child pose. Go inside and become very, very soft. Feel what is moving inside and notice the freedom to move. It is not so important what is moving. It is important that movement can happen and that you can be aware of it. This is just practice, generating currents of aliveness and seeing how they flow. Palms a little in front of your shoulders, lift to table position. Knees touching. On an inhalation, lift your left knee straight out to the side, fire hydrant position. 90-degree angles at the hip and the knee, shin parallel to the mat with both arms straight. Breathe. We have a capacity for experience, and life challenges us, often pushing us beyond our capacity. We want to increase our capacity to experience, to increase our toleration for life, for its ecstasy, its agony, for all in life that helps us to grow and become more true, more real. Begin to circle the knee. Start slow and small, and let the circles grow, reaching out ever wider. Extend the foot out into side kick position. Bring your toes as far forward as you can. Lift the foot, but keep both arms straight. Spread the toes, press out through the heel. Adjust your alignment until there is equal weight on both hands. Breathe deeply. Can you stay open? Can you choose to feel this much? Can you tolerate this much aliveness? On an exhalation, bend the left knee and sit the left foot in between your hands, heel just a few inches beyond your fingertips. Curl the right toes under and lift to lunge. Left knee over the ankle, right heel points straight up, back leg straight. Lower your hips as much as you can. Hold them there as you raise your hands to your hips. Lift your pubic bone, drop your tailbone. Posteriorly rotate your pelvis so that your spine can be most vertical. And from that vertical position, grow an arch by sweeping your hands down, arms out to the sides and up overhead. Flare your ribs, roll the shoulders back and down. Reach up and forward through your sternum, up and back through your fingertips. Press your pelvis down. Focus your gaze, or close your eyes if that is appropriate. Spread your fingers wide. Radiate aliveness out from your center, from your solar plexus. Fill the solar plexus with breath, and let it radiate out. Exhale your arms forward and down. Lower your back knee. Come to child pose. Go inside. Be soft. And feel what is moving. Notice how alive you are right now. What would it mean to let even more aliveness move through you? Pain, fear, and desire shrink us. We become that which wants and that which fears. When the aliveness level grows, we become too big to want or fear. Palms a little in front of your shoulders, lift to table position, and prepare for downward facing dog. Curl your toes under, and lift your knees just a few inches off your mat. Press your hips back until there is stretch from your wrist to your hips. Grow the stretch. Reach your hips back so strongly that your hands want to slide towards your body, but don't let it happen. Keep the stretch strong as you pull your shoulder blades down your back and way out to the sides. Open your shoulders. Bring equal stretch through belly and back. Hold all of your length as you begin to lift your tailbone and press your heels down. Start to straighten your legs. Breathe. Let yourself be stretched. Not just your body. Let your heart be stretched in its capacity to feel. Let your mind be stretched. Let your identity be stretched by the posture as it reveals that you are not what you thought you were. Bring your feet close to each other, big toes touching if you can. Shift your weight onto your left foot. And on an inhalation, lift your right leg straight out behind you. Lift as high as you can, let the hip roll open, and reach through your toes. Imagine there's a switch on the wall behind you about 8 feet high, and you want to flip that switch with your big toe. Don't just reach with the leg. Reach with your waist, reach with your shoulders, reach with your wrists. And with every breath, reach, lengthen more. Take one more deep breath, and on the exhalation, bend the right knee and step the foot between your hands, lunge position. Back heel points straight up, back leg straight. Lower your hips as much as you can without bending your back knee, and raise your hands to your hips. Stabilize here. In lunge position, extend your arms straight out to the sides, parallel to the floor. Inhale, lengthen your waist upward. On the exhale, begin to twist to the right. Your left arm comes forward and your right arm reaches behind. Twist as much as you can through your waist, and there will be a point where the waist loses its ability to take you farther. At that point, reach through your fingers. As if your fingers were little horses pulling wagons, Let the reaching fingers pull the shoulders. Let the shoulders follow and the waist be pulled more deeply into the twist. Keep your pelvis square to the front. Reach equally forward and back so your torso doesn't lean. Gaze towards your right fingertips. Breathe deeply. On an exhale, unwind and continue twisting to the left. Roll onto the big toe side of your left foot, straighten your right leg. Twist your hips to the left and reach out through your right fingertips over your right leg for triangle posture. Reach as far as you can. And as you reach through your right fingertips, reach back through your left to pull your left shoulder away from your ear. Keep your back long and your belly short. If there is any discomfort in your right knee, hold it slightly unlocked. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, rotate arms and shoulders for triangle. No support from down below unless it is a conscious choice. If you need to adjust the distance between your feet, come out of the posture and do so. Feet closer together is easier. Breathe. On an inhalation, lift your right arm out behind you. Your left arm lowers until your chest is parallel to the floor. Bend your right knee. Come up onto the big toe of your left foot and then lift your left leg. Straighten your right leg for balancing airplane posture. Hold your shoulders a little higher than your hips, fingertips a little higher than your shoulders, and then see if you can lift the left heel to the height of your fingertips. Breathe. Again, our capacity to experience becomes challenged. Can you stay present? Can you stay expanded? Can you feel the aliveness that is flowing through every cell? If you can take it farther, sweep your arms forward to Warrior Three. Here you want to lift the arms behind your ears, fingertips as high as you can, and then try to lift the left heel to the same height as the fingertips. Take one more breath. On the exhalation, bring your hands to your hips. Begin to bend your right knee and reach back with the ball of your left foot. Set it back as far as you can in lunge position. Settle into your lunge, make any adjustments that you need to your alignment, and then release your hands down. Sweep them forward, brush the floor, reach forward, lengthen out, and arc up to warrior. Fingertips up and back, sternum up and forward, sink your hips down, take three breaths if you can. Exhale your arms forward and down to your mat. Step back to a bent knee down dog for one breath. And then melt to child pose. Completely relax. Be very soft inside. Sometimes it feels like there are limits to our opening. We think, I can only open this far. But the ancient masters of yoga have said that there is really no limit to the opening. So no matter what your mind tells you, there is more freedom. No matter what your mind tells you that you are more. Palms a little in front of your shoulders, lift to table position, and prepare for downward facing dog. Curl your toes under and lift your knees just a few inches. Keep them close to the mat if you can. Press your hips back and create stretch from wrist joints to hip joints. Create lines of stretch connecting these two points. Keep your hips reaching back as you pull your shoulder blades down your back and way out to the sides. Reach the crown of your head towards your thumbs. Stretch belly and back equally. Hold all the length through your upper body and begin to stretch your lower body. Begin to lift your tailbone and press your heels down. Breathe. Ideally, you want equal stretch through your upper and lower body. It is easy to lose the stretch in your upper body when you straighten your legs. If that happens, it is better to keep the legs a little bent and the upper body lengthening. Bring your feet close to each other, shift your weight onto your right foot, and inhale the left leg out and up behind you. The hips roll open, reach through your toes. From your palms to the tips of your toes, how much length can you generate? Reach through your toes, and then reach just as strongly through your waist, through your shoulders. Reach through your wrists. Let your whole body become one long line of reaching. And with every breath, reach a little more. Become reaching itself. On an inhalation, bend the left knee and sit the foot between your hands, lunge position. Back heel pointing up, back leg straight. Lower your hips as much as you can without bending the back knee, and then raise your hands. Let them rest on your hips. Stabilize and lunge, and then extend your arms straight out to the sides. Inhale, lengthen your waist. And on the exhale, stay long as you twist to the left. Reach equally through both hands to keep your torso from leaning forward. When your waist has twisted as much as it can, begin to twist from your fingertips. Reach through your fingertips to give balance. Gaze towards your left fingers, inhale deeply. On an exhalation, unwind and twist the other way. Roll onto the big toe side of your right foot and straighten your left leg. Twist your hips to the right and begin to extend forward for triangle. If there is any discomfort in your left knee, hold it slightly unlocked. Reach forward through your left fingertips, reach back through your right fingertips. Let your reaching stretch your shoulders. Keep your back long, belly short. Pull pubic bone towards sternum. Extend, reach, and then rotate arms and shoulders for triangle. Keep your hips square to the side wall as best as you can. Belly and back equally long. Neck long, shoulders open. Pull your shoulder joints out to the sides, as far away from your spine as you can. On an inhalation, bend your left knee. Sweep your left arm out behind you. Right arm and hip move forward until your chest is parallel to the floor. Lift your right foot and straighten your right leg behind you for balancing airplane posture. Find your way of working this posture. You can focus on lifting the raised leg, straight or bent, or you could focus on leveling your hips. You can focus on lifting the shoulders to open your chest and strengthen your upper back muscles. You can focus on doing the posture with steadiness, improving your balance. If you can take it farther, sweep your arms in front of you for Warrior Three. Open your shoulders, lengthen, reach forward, and then with equal intensity, reach back through your right foot. Let your reaching give you steadiness. On an exhalation, bring your hands to your hips. Begin to bend your left knee and reach back with the ball of your right foot. Set it back as far as you can in lunge position. Settle into your lunge and then release your hands down. Sweep them forward. Brush the floor with your fingertips if you can. Reach forward, lengthen out, and open the front of your body to warrior. Keep the back of your body open too. Create a long, graceful arc from your hip joints to the crown of your head. Breathe deeply, three breaths, if you can. Bring your arms forward and down, fingertips on either side of your left foot, and step up to ragdoll. Both feet together, hang very, very softly. Bend your knees as much as you need to for your lower back to be comfortable. As you hang, feel what you feel. Feel who you are right now, when you aren't divided, partially in the past, partially in the future. When you are all right here. Imagine taking this much presence into any task, to any relationship. Slowly bend your knees until your thighs are parallel to your mat as best as you can. If you feel discomfort or instability in your knees, you need to lift the hips a little higher. Raise your hands to your hips and lift your sternum really high. Sweep your arms forward and up, then out to the sides and behind you. Interlace fingers, press your knuckles towards the wall behind you, sternum towards the wall to the front. Reach up through your crown, butt reaches back and down. Hold and breathe deeply. Take three breaths to slowly rise up. Take your time. It is going to feel so good at the top. Stay present. Can you stay open to all that you feel all along the way? When you're all the way up, release your hands, sweep your arms out to the sides and up, interlace your fingers, steeple position, and reach upward. Exhale, and then inhale, lengthen some more. Stay long through your torso and float your arms out and down. Bring your hands to your belly. Hold your belly in your hands. Feel. Feel the aliveness that is moving through you right now. Turn 90 degrees to your right and spread your legs one leg length apart. Toes point straight ahead or slightly in. Having your feet too far apart can cause discomfort in your ankles or knees. If you are feeling discomfort in one of those places, move your feet a little closer. Hands on your hips, slide your hands around to your back so that your thumbs touch on your sacrum. Press your hands forward and down into your hips to open your chest. Flare your ribs and lift your sternum. Keep the openness, the arch in your back, as you begin to lift your tailbone behind you and hinge forward to jackknife position. Come forward only as far as you can without losing the arch in your back. Breathe and relax into all the stretch you feel in the backs of your legs. If you want to take it farther, without losing the arch in your back, take your arms out to the sides, fingertips a little higher than your shoulders. If you can, take it even farther, by sweeping your arms in front of you. Make a V with your arms and work to bring your arms above your ears. Breathe. Reach forward or out through your fingertips. Reach back with your hips and lengthen your back. Take a deep breath. And on the exhalation, lower your arms and round your back. Fingertips on the mat for support. Without bending your knees, wobble your hips from side to side. Bring your left hand over in front of your right foot, palms or fingertips on the mat. Inhale your right arm out to the side and up overhead. Twist and reach. Twist as much as you can through your arms and shoulders, and then work to pull the twist down into your waist. Breathe deeply as you stretch. Exhale your right arm down. Take your right hand over in front of your left foot. Inhale, twist to the left. Arm out to the side and up. Twist through arm and shoulder, and then work to pull the twist down into your waist. Breathe deeply. And for a little extra work, lengthen. Pull your ribs away from your hips. One more breath in. On the exhalation, sweep the left arm down. Take support from your hands. Bend both knees and lower yourself to a lying position on your back with your legs extended. Take two breaths here and let go of all doing for these few moments. Become very soft in the flow of aliveness.